In Tolkien's The Fellowship of the Ring, Frodo says to Gandalf, "I wish it need not have happened in my time." Gandalf says, "So do I, and so do all who live to see such times, but that is not for them to decide. All we have to decide is what to do with the time that is given us." History is full of choices. Face down the enemy or surrender, fight the long odds or turn away, garner hope or accept despair. But it's the choices that don't feel like choices at all that can, as often, define us. French philosopher Albert Camus never believed that his fight against totalitarianism was ever a choice, but the only response available to him. Overnight in early March of this year, our world changed. The truth was that the existence of our school could no longer be safely assumed. The truth was that Lakefield, a school heavily reliant on welcoming students from over 40 countries, abruptly found itself in a world where all air travel had ceased. The truth was that in an ecosystem that was reliant on academics, sports, theater, and dance, it wasn't immediately conceivable how these could operate when we could not be together. But underlying all this was a starker truth. Students may have to go to school, but they didn't have to go to Lakefield College. When other leaders wavered, ours told us the truth, because the truth was never a choice to them either, because the truth was hard and we could take it, because the truth wasn't going to set anyone free, but it would galvanize every teacher, every coach, every student, and every person who cared about the school. And they were right. Staff immediately took a pay cut and then proceeded to work harder and longer because Lakefield was never just a place to work, a job, or a paycheck, or a place to raise a family. Lakefield was a calling, a movement, and the spring of 2020, it was a mission. When other schools shut down, suspending their operations and forsaking their ideals, we advanced into ours, doubling down in ways that would have been both foreign and familiar to our alumni. In 7 days, we reinvented school itself, learning on the fly the potential of virtual curriculum delivery and then executing it. When other schools surrendered their athletics and arts, we reinvented those too, offering virtual programs in running, cycling, cooking, yoga, dance, soccer, and basketball. Teachers created free online courses for the Lakefield and frontline community on the Vietnam War, sports leadership, entrepreneurship, and positive psychology. Because we never forgot that sports, arts, and an enterprising curiosity were never really about the games played, the classes taught, or the plays performed, but about learning and striving together. And if we couldn't do that in person, we'd find another way until we could. 6 months later, when other schools kept their gymnasiums closed, curtailed their classes, and shuttered their theaters, we moved back in time and back outside. Our waterfront became a dance studio. Our fields, long the home of soccer and field hockey, also became badminton and volleyball courts, and the venue for spirit events every Friday night. The outdoor rink became basketball courts, the grove our chapel, and the wild places became our classrooms. The health center team created a COVID center. Joe McRae rebuilt a modular schedule that would allow students to arrive at different times. In short, we didn't desert who we were, we concentrated it, because the truths that guided us, the values that grounded us, never changed. Education disconnected from the outdoors, untethered from relationships, divorced from character may be commonplace in other schools, but were incoherent to LCS. It was an understanding that our students also carried with them. This past spring and summer, Sophie 22 baked bread for frontline workers. Abigail 23 and her family cleaned up for Earth Day. James 20 helped neighbors get groceries. And staff member Jeff Bemrose and his daughter, Kate, 22, performed and submitted a dance video for COVID. We turned into the challenge and the fear and the uncertainty because that's what we have always done. Lakefield students have fought Canada's wars, served their country in government, fire departments, hospitals, and police forces. Throughout Lakefield College's 141-year history, its students have sacrificed for people they didn't know, fought hateful ideologies on distant battlefields, treated the sick in hospital triage centers, and given last rites to the dying. Every year, it is LCS students from all over the world who stand outside local businesses, stoically selling poppies. Every November, it is LCS students from around the world who in a sublime act of symmetry stand for men they too would never know in a country far from their own. In the final episode of Friday Night Lights, football coach Eric Taylor says to his team that everyone at some point is going to lose a battle, that they are going to fight and they are going to lose. But what defines them is that in the midst of the battle, they do not lose themselves. This theme of accepting that the odds are stacked, the dice are loaded, and the chances of success negligible, and then fighting anyway, is a refrain that stretches from Beowulf to Rocky. There is nothing inevitable about Lakefield College, nothing guaranteed, and nothing certain, except the people. Miss Key was right. The world needs us, and this is our time.